Hey, sehr und Konnichiwa. Hier ist wieder euer Keanu. Zurück mit dem ersten Projekt dieser Art. Höchstwahrscheinlich in Deutsch und keine. Nein, also. In Deutschland so. Egal. Ja, Klanert, ihr habt abgestimmt. Und die Abstimmung ist wie folgt ausgefallen. Ein Part wird 30 Minuten lang sein. Ich werde wahrscheinlich alle 10 Minuten mal einen kurzen Cut machen. Einfach mal zu gucken, wie sieht's aus? Ist alles so, wie es sein soll? Und um meine Stimme ein bisschen zu stonen, beziehungsweise zwischendurch mal was zu trinken oder blablabla. Und das Zweite, es wird hörspielartig, englisch, mit Emotionen sein. Ich bin, naja, etwas nervös, sag ich jetzt mal. Da das ja eine ganz neue Art ist. Ich hoffe, das ist verständlich. Ich werde aber mal gucken, wie das wird. Ich hoffe, das wird so, wie ich es mir vorstelle. Und zwar cool. Mal gucken, wie. Ich werde übrigens nur ein Ende zeigen. Es gibt, glaube ich, sechs verschiedene Enden in dem Spiel. Und wie gesagt, ich werde nur ein Ende zeigen. Ah, dann fangen wir einfach mal an mit Clannad. New Game. Awful surface of white. Snow. Yes, snow. Continuing to fall down even now. It covers my body in white. What am I doing in such a world? Since when have I been alone in this place? Buried in snow was my hand. That hand was holding something. I pull it up. A hand of pure white. It was a girl's hand. Ah, that's right. I was not alone. I brushed off the snow covering her face. Her figure was slapped quietly surfaced. That's right. We were always together. In this world. In this sad, lonely world. I hate this town. Because it's a place dead with memories I want to forget. Every day, going to school, chatting with friends, then going to home I don't like. Nothing new ever happens. I wonder if anything will ever change like this. I wonder if my life will ever be any different. The untouched and natural growth of this town, the weaving around hills to get to school. I wonder how convenient it would be to attend school if you could wipe off all these hills. If I could take a straight path, it would probably cut down my walking time by 20 minutes. One day, 20 minutes. So then, how much time will I save in a year? I do the math as I walk. I don't know. There aren't any other students from my school around. Normally, since this is the main path to school, it should be bristling with them. It's not like today is a holiday or anything, which means now it isn't the time for people to be arriving at school. I ignore this laid-back image though and continue walking at the same speed. 200 meters until I reach the school gates, I stand for a bit. Taking a breath, I look up at the sky. Presented by Key. The school gates are just ahead. Who decided to put the gates all the way up there? This long road is stretching out like a nightmare. It It's a different breath from mine, smaller, more gentle. I look beside me. There's a girl standing as still as I am. I can tell that she's 30 years student by the color of her badge. But she isn't someone I know. Her short hair is fluttering in the wind just above her shoulders. She looks like she's about to cry. I don't usually judge people by appearance, but she looks very honest. She looks like the kind of girl who would like to time to enter the classroom alone. She closes her eyes and nods repeatedly for a few moments, as if she had something to tell herself. Then she opens her eyes. She looks at the tall school gate with a firm eye.
Do you like the school?
Huh? No, she probably wasn't speaking to me. She was probably speaking to someone inside her heart. How would this man, or perhaps woman, answer her?
I really, really do. But nothing can remain the same forever. Even fun things and happy things, nothing. Nothing stays that way forever.
With great difficulty, she continues to speak.
Even so, can you still like this place?
You just have to find it, right?
Huh?
Suppressed, she looks at me. As if she believed that she was alone until now. You just have to find the next fun or happy thing, right? It's wrong to think that there's only one thing like that. That's right. There were times when we are innocent and naive. It's a phase everyone goes through. Come on, let's go.
Ich will mein schlechtes Englisch an dieser Stelle mal kurz entschuldigen. Er ist doch schon ein bisschen was anderes.
Der 14. April. Tsunohara. The teacher calls out the name of a single student. Absent as usual. I glance at Tsunohara's seat beside me. His attendance is even worse than mine. We are the only two students in this class known as delinquents. I guess that's why we get along. Also, he's the only person I can really talk to freely. That's how we are. The lesson has started. I spent my time looking out the window, ignoring everything the teacher's saying. The class has ended and school is over. The Tsunohara didn't show up at all. In the end, the only person I talked to today was a girl from this morning. Today is no different from any other day. I'm not part of any club, so I pick up my empty bag and slip out the classroom while the rest of the students are chatting away. Even if I go home, there won't be anyone there right now. I don't have a mother to begin with. She died in a car accident when I was young. I don't even remember her face. My father, who was left behind, sank into depression, probably affected by the shock of her death. He'd go out, get drunk, and waste his time gambling. My entire childhood was wasted from always fighting with him. But after a certain accident, our relationship changed. He became violent and injured me. From that day forward, my father kept his soul throughout to himself. Then, instead of calling me in the normal way, he started calling me Tomoya-kun, with a kun at the end, as I thought I were a stranger. Without a doubt, that made us feel unrelated. just like a closed shell. Just like a point in time that separates the present from the past. It would be been better if he had just completely ignored me. If he cared enough to cause me pain, there would be still hope. But now, if he sees me come home, he smiles if he's seeing an old friend and begins to shed. It would cause me so much pain that I couldn't take it anymore. I would rush out of the house. And so, in order to avoid him, I have lived my life not returning home until late at night, after he was asleep. I go to sleep at dawn and wake up around noon. Ever since I entered high school, I've always been late. This has been going on for 3 years. Today, as always, I changed my clothes and left before my father go home. That's what I've become used to. I roam around the town at night, and I end up going to the same place at the end of the day. I buy my dinner at the convenience store, and with it in hand, I head down the school slope towards the student dormitory. The school actively promotes club activities, so there are lots of students here. They spend their 3 years here away from the parents. They are very different from a person who left out the school life with no dreams like this. It's none of my business, but in this place, he, Tsunohara, lives here. Even Tsunohara got into the school for sports, as he was once a part of the soccer team. But in his first year, he got into a big fight with students from another school and got suspended. He was removed from being a regular player. And then, after his freshman year, he lost his place on the team. There was nothing he could do but leave them. As he couldn't really afford to move anywhere else, he ended up remaining in this dorm, which is reserved for students of sports clubs.
How many times I have to tell you? But the volume was really low.
Tsunohara is there. He's in front of another room, taking with a student with a huge body.
Even that's really low, I can hear it through the thin walls. Use your headphones.
I told you, I cannot afford that.
Then you listen to it.
No, but I don't, then I can't really get in the mood, you know. And it's a really cool song, you know. Look, if you just listen to the lyrics, you will know that I mean.
I don't care what the hell you mean. All you doing is pissing me off. If I hear it again, I'm kicking you out of here. Bam!
Tsunohara's head slumps down before the closed door.
Damn, that rugby player,
he mumbles to himself. He's not gonna heal like that.
Damn that rugby player!
I correct him with a yell as he stands beside me. Tsunohara grabs me by the hand and drags me into his room. In the hallway, a large voice bellows,
"Who the hell was that?"
Are you trying to get me killed?
You're the one who said that, aren't you?
You know, Okazaki, I'm not at good terms with the residents here these days. So, let's go all out right now. We still got a year left.
You really don't have any guts, do you?
Hey, I wouldn't back down in a one-on-one fight, if it's with a rugby player. But all the rooms around are rugby player rooms. If I stir up something here, it
gonna be too dangerous. But, well, when it's near graduation, going all out would be nice.
When the time comes, Okazaki, I'll have you cover my back.
Lucky, I'll stab you well.
Not me, got that damp!
But I'm on the rugby team side, you see.
Since when?
Well, just the time.
What? Why?
Then what the hell have we been doing for the last 2 years, huh?
Dung!
Boy shakes. An angry short saying, "Be quiet!" follows after that.
I'll kick back.
Don't do it!
You're way too jumpy. Please, try to put yourself in my position. Will you?
He's crying.
I'm begging you, just shut up, please.
Okay. That miserable look is overpowering me.
Kleine Anmerkung, diese Szene gerade konnte unter meinen Fandubs auf meinem Channel gesehen werden.
Hermann aus. I began eating from my lunchbox, sitting between the kotetsu and the wall of the small room.
Tea, please. I don't have any.
That's why I said please, right?
I don't care if you bow. I said I don't have any.
You're not
confusing this room with a cafeteria, are you?
This is your room, I know.
Okay.
And you're my slave.
You don't seem to get it, do you?
Come on, man. I forgot to buy it.
Didn't it even occur to you that you should get it yourself?
But you said your helping me is your only purpose on life. Ever since I saved you, right?
I don't have such a meta backstory!
Didn't you say it like this after I saved you?
The man called Sunohara died at that moment. The person here right now is just someone who will serve you tea.
So tea?
Don't make up such a crap!
Then I'll settle for a last cup of tea.
There's no such thing as first or last!
Oh god, this is touching. If you listen to this, you'll definitely want to get tea from me. Losing the battle against a fatal injury, there was no hope left of saving you. At Inzit's condition, you were committed to bringing me tea, for I was thirsty. From there, you squeezed out every last ounce of your strength as you crawled up to me to pour some tea. And then...
Master Okazaki, here's some tea. And this will be your last tea. You were smiling where you died.
And I was so damn satisfied with that, huh?
That was what you hoped for after all.
And then, while crying, I drank the last cup of tea.
Touching, isn't it?
So tea. I said I don't have any.
After that, I spent the rest of the day reading magazines. There wasn't a TV to watch, so there was nothing to do except read.
Phew.
Isn't time to go to sleep? The sun already set and it's night time.
Yeah, you're right.
I don't plan on sleeping in Tsunohara's room. If I wake up seeing this guy in the morning, I'll just be depressed.
Then I'm gonna go take a shower.
Okay.
Sunohara grabs a towel from a mountain of clothing in the corner and leaves the room.
I want to avoid having to see Sunohara when he's get back. I guess I should go home. I stop reading the magazine and get up. Then I notice a cassette player in front of me. It looks like there's a tape inside. So I push the play button.
This is old-fashioned hip-hop.
Disgusting. Who's gonna listen to this crap?
Okay, I record my own original rap instead. The time will be to my best friend Sunohara's rap.
Z
This will definitely impress him. Here we go. I take a deep breath and press the record button. Yo, yo, I'm Okazaki, you are... With the tempo down, I begin to spin my words. You're... Damn, nothing's come to my mind. Forget it, this is stupid. I throw a swift punch in frustration. Why the hell do I have to do something like this for him anyway? It's not like we are close friends or anything to begin with. I'm out of here. I decide to leave before Tsunade returns. April 15. She's there again. You again? Why aren't you going on ahead?
That's... Well, how should I put it?
It's okay. You don't have to force yourself to say it. I'm a stranger after all.
Okay.
But you know, you should be serious about going to school on time.
You're late as well.
She points her finger at me. It's okay for me. I turn my eyes away. To begin with, what am I so serious about? Lecturing a stranger? That's right. It's like she said. She's also a delinquent. Do whatever you want. I leave her alone and start ascending the hill by myself. It's just that she doesn't look like a delinquent at all, so I felt like lecturing her. So, that's the only reason.
Please wait!
A voice. It's that girl?
Is it okay for me to follow you?
I look back to see her standing there beside me. Why?
Because I feel uneasy going alone.
She's confessing to a strange kid like me. She probably has at least one or two friends. So why is it me again? I narrow my eyes as I gaze up the hill. Well, it's only a short walk from here. Do what you want. I say that and start walking again.
Please wait.
What now? She's looking at me when...
Pam,
she says. How should I respond to that? French loaf.
I don't understand what you're saying.
That's my line. Or do you just like Aunt Pan?
No, not really. Though, that said, I don't really hate it. Or as I like it.
She's a roundabout person. Anything is fine with me. Let's go.
Okay.
It seems that reply cheered her up a little bit. Her words were like a charm. I continue to hear her footsteps falling behind me. The lesson ends up with the ring of the school chimes. A voice suddenly makes me turn my head.
Fujibashiru?
She's the class representative. Or rather, to be precise, she was voted in.
If I remember correctly, she's Kyo's younger twin sister.
Her eyes keeps on darting back and forth as she comes by my desk. What?
Here.
She presents a sheet of paper to me. A love letter?
No, it's not.
I didn't think you were that bald. You've got really guts to be giving me something like this.
It's not a love letter.
Then a death threat? I don't think it's nice to just hand something like this directly to me.
It's not a death threat.
A challenge? But
Fujibashi's face reddens as she forces that shell of pepper into my chest.
It's the brain dart from homeroom this morning.
That's it? Boring. I take the printout and shove it inside my desk without looking at it. It probably isn't worth seeing anyway.
What? Is there something else? Well, I think it's better if you come to school on time.
It's none of your business, really.
But, well, I'd be better if you came to school on time, so...
So, if you become the class representative, you can just talk about your other classmates' attendance, huh?
That's not what I mean, but...
Her eyes are becoming misty. Maybe I was a little rough. Sorry, I spoke a bit too much.
No, it's my fault for bothering you so much. Sorry.
Hey, Yokozaki, don't make our class rep cry, will ya? That's just as going to be after you.
It's okay, I'm not crying.
I don't think that's what you should say when tears are boiling up in your eyes. At least, they aren't falling from her eyes yet, so let's not do something what will make her cry. Well, I'll take that your advice.
Okay. But if you can, try not to be late.
With that said, Fujibashi pulls a deck of cards out of her pocket. Then, she clumsily plays the cards in her hand and shuffles them. Cards fell over the ground. She quickly gathers the scattered cards and tries shuffling again. Seems she got it right this time. She forms a badly shaped fan with the cards and presents it to me. What?
Please?
Want me to pick one?
Pick three cards, please.
I don't know what the hell is going on. Is she going to show me a magic trick? Anyway, I pick out the three cards.
Please show them to me.
Here. She carefully inspects the cards I picked.
Okazaki-kun, you'll be late tomorrow.
Is she trying to pick a fight with me or something? Hey, aren't you the one who told me not to be late? So, what the hell is that about?
Well, you encounter an old lady in trouble at the pedestrian crossing on your way here. You'll be late if you help her. But you'll receive a lot of gratitude and payment.
Wait a second. What's with this overly detailed fortune telling? How could you tell me that with plain cards? They're not even tarot cards. Exactly. What kind of premise do you have based on signs and marks alone?
It's immense inspiration.
Sixth sense in full power. Even more, she is pretty confident. Could it be that you don't want me to come to school?
That's not it. It's just that's how the fortune turned out.
Fine, I definitely won't be late tomorrow. I'm just gonna ignore that old lady at the pedestrian crossing.
I don't think that's a good idea. I think it's better to try to help people in trouble.
No, I'll just leave her alone.
But...
Dang, 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 dang. Look, the bell's ringing, so go back to your seat.
Okay...
Fujibashi drops her shoulders, looking depressed, and goes back to her seat. Jeez, I'm the one who's becoming depressed here.
What? people shouldn't really worry about that fortune telling I made.
After saying that, she slowly returns to her seat. Maybe she really is trying to pick a fight with me. The result of her unusual fortune telling makes me worry a little.